Hello, Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer matter of teaching Christianity. Here I render exposition of Gnostic Gospel of Truth, translated by Robert M. Grant, part 16. It is thus that each one has acted, that means the person, as if he were asleep. That means once, when you are once born, you are like a slept person during the time when he was ignorant. Ignorant means he was once born, and thus he comes to understand as if he were awakening. So when he comes to understand, then he is getting awakening, that getting twice born. Remember, for the once born people, their duty to learn, improve there is to ask a question. Ask, and those who are twice born, they should seek, and those who are served, to serve, to serve. Those who are sealed to serve God, they should knock at the door of our Father by taking Eucharist. And happy is the man who comes to himself, that means comes to his senses. As the blind man whose eyes Christ Jesus opened with spittle came to his own senses and awakens, that he become in an awakened state of mind. Indeed, blessed is he, the apostle, who has opened the eyes of the spiritually blind people. And the Spirit came to him in haste. Then once he started asking, explaining things of God to the person, then the Spirit, common sense, come to him in a haste, that means quick, because he understands the things through logical reasoning. So mostly people who are farmers, who are simple-minded people, they are more capable of logical reasoning than those people who are town people, who have read the letters. They always deal with what is written down. They don't understand what is not written down is understood through logical reasoning. So they are drunk with the old wine of the letters. They cannot take the things of the Spirit or of common sense. And the Spirit came to him in haste when it raised him from the dead in letters. So person lying on the floor is dead in letters, but when the Spirit come, it awakens him. Having given its helping hand to the one lying prone on the ground. Prone means that prone to be victim of the temple priest, or the people are prone to be victim of the Pope, the Antichrist. So many people get pruned to their clerics, to their bishops, and they eat them away. So they do not let them go to the royal kingdom of God. Pruned on the ground, it, Holy Spirit, placed him firmly on his feet. Holy Spirit is common sense. You know, these people who call themselves atheists, they exercise common sense. So they are on their firm footing. They are twice born. For he had not yet stood up. Stood up means he has stood up on his own feet. That means he has not become as the master of his own destiny, or a male in spirit, a man in spirit. That is why we are fishers of men, of those who are twice born, and who are standing on their own feet. That is, when one is once born, then one is helplessly lying on the ground as dead, that the vultures, the temple priests, and the antichrists, such as the popes, clerics, bishops, could easily divulge them. And it is by the grace of our Father that we are made alive and alive, capable of standing firmly over our own feet to fight the Antichrist, the vultures. So it is only by the grace of our Father that we get Holy Spirit, and then we come to our senses and stand on our own feet. Remember, a person who is drunk, he is normally lying on the floor, but when his drunkenness disappears, he comes back to his senses, then he stands up on the ground and start walking. But the temple priest, when they put the scriptures before them, which is the old mind, and they kept them drunk, then they have no capability of standing on their own feet or understanding his word. That's why Christ Jesus said, when he came in the middle of the world in Jerusalem, he found the people in Jerusalem drunk with the old wine, desiring not the new. So he was disappointed. That's why Christ Jesus, the preaching of Christ Jesus or the ministry of Christ Jesus was not that effective in Jerusalem as it was effective in the villages, where people were less drunk with the old wine of the letters. He, our Father, gave them, the twice-born people, the means is Holy Spirit or common sense of knowing the knowledge is his word of the Father, and the revelations, the parables of his Son, Christ Jesus. His Christ Jesus gave us introduction to our Father through parables. Only then you understand parables and know our Father. For when they perceived the Son of God, the Christ, and not saw it, and listened to it, his word, he permitted them to take a taste of and to smell and to grasp the beloved Son. That means people, you know, they were, when they understood the gospel, they received the taste, but many people, they said, hey, what's the use of this knowledge if it doesn't make money? So for the sake of business and money, you know, they did not take on this knowledge. They had the taste and smell and even had the feeling of our brother Christ Jesus, but they rejected him. They went for mammon and not for money. So very few people went for gospel. Then they got sealed to serve God. That is, they were able to understand his word. He, Christ Jesus, appeared informing them, the twice born people of the Father, the illimitable one, infinite. He inspired them with that which is in the mind, his word, while doing his will and not his own will. Remember that Christ Jesus came to do the will of our Father and not his own will, as these Pope and all these Antichrist are doing their wills. They don't do the will of our Father. Many received the light and turned towards him. Many who were clean-hearted and not greedy cheats heard his word, heard his voice, and turned to him. The Christ Jesus of their free will, turned to Christ Jesus of their free will. Nobody forced them. So they, in Christ Jesus, when you hear his word, then you have attraction or fellow for understanding his word, and then you follow him automatically of your free will. He doesn't ask you to follow him, because only the blind follow the others. So you follow him for the sake of knowledge.